Hello children, today let us study standard 6 physics chapter number 7 magnetism the remaining part. The end of the magnet here, suppose this is the magnet, the end of the magnet here it is having the north pole and here it is the south pole. Okay, if we take the freely suspended magnet, then the end that points toward the geographic north is the north seeking pole or simply the north pole, and the end that points toward the geographic south is the south seeking pole or the south pole. And this distance between north and south, okay, the distance between the north pole and the south pole of the magnet, this distance is called the effective length of the magnet. This distance from north pole to south pole, this is called the effective length of the magnet. And this imaginary line that passes through the north pole and south pole, magnetic south pole of the bar magnet, okay, this XY imaginary line which passes through magnetic north and magnetic south pole of the magnet, this imaginary line is called magnetic axis. Okay, then comes the magnetic equator. Here children, you can see this imaginary line PQ, okay, which bisects this effective length of the magnet. Effective length is the distance between this north pole and the south pole. Okay, so this imaginary line which bisects the effective length of the magnet is called the magnetic equator. I hope you all have understood the different terms which are related to the bar magnet. Now let us learn about the magnetic force, magnetic field lines, okay, and the magnetic field of the magnet. So let us start with the magnetic force. Children, what is magnetic force? The force which is exerted by a magnet, that's called a magnetic force. Okay, it is a non-contact force. Why it is said to be a non-contact force? Because it acts at a distance. The region around the magnet where the magnetic force can be felt, that region is called the magnetic field. Okay, and this magnetic field, they are represented by using the curved lines which are called magnetic line of force. Here in this diagram you can see the magnetic line of force. Children, the magnetic line of force, they originate from the north pole and they move toward the south pole. Okay, so here you can see very well that how the magnetic field lines, they are originating from the north pole and moving toward the south pole. Children, here in this diagram you can see a horseshoe magnet and how the magnetic lines of force is drawn around this horseshoe magnet. You can see it is originating from the north pole and moving toward the south pole. Here originating from the north pole, moving toward the south pole. Here also you can see originating from the north pole, it will move like this and then here moving toward the south pole. Now let us learn about the properties of magnetic line of force. Okay, now here you can see magnetic line of force, these are the continuous curves. Okay, these are the continuous curves which start from the north pole and moves toward the south pole. Children, here I have said you that it originates from the north pole and moves toward the south pole. But inside the magnet, this direction is just opposite. ओके ना, इनसाइड द मैग्नेट दिस डायरेक्शन इज जस्ट अपोजिट, इट स्टार्ट विथ साउथ पोल एंड मूव टूअर्ड द नॉर्थ पोल, बट वेन एवर द डायग्राम इज सेड यू विल बी ड्रॉइंग लाइक दिस इटसेल्फ, है ना, ओरिजिनेटिंग फ्रॉम द नॉर्थ पोल एंड मूविंग टूअर्ड द साउथ पोल, इज दैट क्लियर, बट इनसाइड दिस मैग्नेट ना ऑलवेज इट इज जस्ट अपोजिट, ओके, इट ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम साउथ एंड मूव्स टूअर्ड द नॉर्थ पोल. Next point is that no two line of force, okay, intersect each other. You cannot see that two line of force, they are meeting at any point. They will not intersect at any point. And magnetic field lines, they are concentrated near the poles of the magnet. Isn't it? Magnetic field lines, they are mainly concentrated towards the poles of the magnet. The arrow mark which is given, it shows you the direction in which this magnetic field lines move. Okay, here this arrow mark. If two magnets are brought near each other where they, with their unlike pole facing each other, then this is how the magnetic field lines are drawn. It starts with the north, move toward the south, this way. Okay, then here itself, it starts with the north and move toward the south. Okay, this is how the magnetic field lines are drawn when two unlike pole facing magnet are brought near each other. If two magnets with their like pole facing each other are brought near each other, then this is how the magnetic line of force is drawn. You can see here, this way, they will ripple, na? Isn't it? So north pole, they will ripple, isn't it? Okay,